In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, to whom we all have to speak. Honorable listeners and respectable audience, you know that we have started a series of linguistics. Day before yesterday, our topic was the difference between the place of articulation and the manner of articulation. I told you that the manner of articulation means that how sounds are produced. Manner of articulation means that how sounds are articulated. Manners of articulation also means that how sounds are formed. Listeners and audience, whenever we are talking about the manner of articulation, two points should be in our mind. The first point, that is comparative. Comparative position of articulators. And the next one, that is nature of obstruction. Listeners and audience, comparative position of articulators mean that what is the position of articulator whenever we are making sound? What is the different positions of articulators when we are producing sounds? Either they are closely open, they are openly open, or they are widely open, or they are narrowly open. I am repeatedly sharing with you about active articulators and passive articulators. The active articulators are those which move toward passive articulators, like our tongue, which is active articulator. Our lower lip, which is active articulator, because it moves in touch with our upper lip. And our tongue, which has parts like tip of the tongue, back of the tongue, blade of the tongue, and back of the tongue. So all these are the parts of the tongue and they are active articulators. And our teeth, our ridge, alveolar ridge, these are passive articulators. They do not move. However, in comparative position of articulators, we are talking about that how sounds are produced and what are the positions of articulators. Either they are openly open, they are widely open, they are closely open or narrowly. And on another one, that is nature of obstruction. Nature of obstruction means that what is obstruction to the passage of air, or what obstruction is there when the air is passing in the production of sound, in the formation of sound. So these two points are very important when we are talking about manner of articulators or manner of articulation. Listeners and audience, I'm going to discuss today's topic. That what's our topic today is? Today our topic is, that is plosive or plosive sounds. Plosive sounds, also known as stops. I will share with you a plosive sounds. Then what are plosive sounds? How plosive sounds are formed? And what things or components or important and required for the production of plosive sounds? Listeners and audience, if you want to know practically about plosive sounds, two points must be there in your mind. The first one, that is complete closure, and the next one, that is sudden release. What is the difference between complete closure and sudden release? Listeners and audience, complete closure means whenever the air is coming from our lungs and then it comes to our articulators and stop in the compressed way. So that is complete closure. Whenever the air is passing, the air is passed from our lungs and then stop and stop in our articulators. So that is called complete closure, because with the coming of the passage of air and the air stop there with our articulators or within our articulators and it the air is compressed, so that is known as complete closure. And sudden release mean that the compressed air, when it is released, when it is freed and escaped. So in sudden release, the compressed air, when it is already stopped in our articulators, when the air is suddenly released or abruptly released, so then it is called sudden release. Now, how many sounds are there in plosive? So there are almost 6 sounds are there in plosive. The past one, that is known as p sound. Next one, that is b, and that is t and t, and k and g. So p, t, t, and k, g. These sounds, they are called plosive. Why they are called plosive? Because whenever the air is coming from our lungs and reach to our articulators, and the air is stopped there in the compressed way, and when it is suddenly or abruptly released with explosion, then we call it sudden release and we completely call it plosive sound. So 6 sounds are there in plosive. We call them, for example, t, p, and k. These sounds are called plosive sounds.